And welcome back, guys. We're going to be playing some more Planetcrafter, and today we are going to be doing the animal shelters and animal feeder. And then eventually, we're going to go and do the last warden door, I believe it is. And I had to go and I sat there for probably like an hour or two trying to look around here, because I knew it was around here somewhere, I just didn't know exactly where. See this red dot? Yep, this is where we got to put three warden keys in. It's going to open up this pathway, and then we're going to be able to loop in there. And it'll open up this area to us, basically. And supposedly there's five warden keys in there that you need to find. Don't know where they are. All I know is there's like five warden keys in there you got to go find. So I went AFK in the base. I left it going for an hour. I came back. I'm on top of the roof, like merged into the roof. Basically, the character died because it didn't have food or water and got stuck on top of the storage containers. Like in the, apparently there's like an open gap in the ceiling there. It's kind of weird. But how did I get unstuck? Well, I had to remove one of the storage containers, which was annoying because it was full of stuff. But yeah, kind of get the idea. Drones have kind of lost their mind at the moment. Has made a bunch of fusion cells and sold them. And they're like, we need to get resources, So, yeah, as you can see, there's a bunch going to the Z-Light Cave right now, bringing back resources. Osmium is being brought back. Uranium has to end up tapping this mine over here with iridium. And this one's tapped as well. Then there's a mine here, 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 here. Here, 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 here. So today's goal, we're gonna, like I said, put this up, and then we'll go ahead and play with some DNA splicing, and then we'll go and make the feeder, and then if we've got time, then maybe we'll do a warden door. Maybe. Make sure to hit the like button, make sure to subscribe button. Let's get into it. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
Alrighty, that looks like a good place to stop. Make sure to like button, make sure to subscribe button, thank you guys for supporting the channel. As you can tell, playing with DNA takes a very long time to figure out what you want. So for instance, I wanted the strikes to originally be like yellow or green or something like that, but we have to go over to the DNA manipulator, go make frog eggs so that we can get the skin pattern color to the hell, wherever the hell we want. I chose red, and it actually turned out pretty cool anyways. But yeah, this is how we get this striped skin color. This is how we play with its DNA by making, you know, fish eggs, and then we put it in the DNA manipulator here, and we can also get, you know, different coloring from this. But you kind of get the idea now of me physically showing me making frog eggs and then making a different version of frog eggs and stick them all in here and bloop. And it's just like, God, this takes forever. Yeah, it does. And there's no way to automate the incubators either. So it's like, shit. Thankfully, I've got the base automated to automatically be making myself terror tokens. Eventually, towards the end, we'll buy everything in the terror shop there. So, make sure to like button, make sure to subscribe button. I'll see you guys in the next video.